Here are 10 new shortcuts ideas, but with a twist. They're specifically for Apple Pencil Pro and the new squeeze gesture. Toggle Stage Manager on your iPad. Automatically open apps in split view with a squeeze on the pencil. Slide over your messages, control your media. And stay tuned for shortcut number 3 because I managed to create a clipboard manager here on iPad. All right, shortcut number 1, and one you're probably going to use a lot when you're messing with these squeeze gesture settings. This shortcut actually opens a URL scheme, which will jump you right to the Apple Pencil settings. If I hit play on this shortcut, you jump right here. I can't find a way to go directly into the squeeze gestures, but now you're one tap away from changing the shortcut that's mapped to the Apple Pencil. I've named all the shortcuts that you can download in the video description via those links, starting with Pencil. This way it makes it easier to search for them just by typing Pencil and it'll pull all these up. If I choose the Pencil Settings shortcut, now wherever I am on my iPad, I can just squeeze my Apple Pencil and I'll be jumped right to those Apple Pencil settings. Number 2, this is a pretty simple one, but I just have a Play Pause My Media toggle here on the iPad. This way, if I'm listening to a podcast or music, I can actually use my Apple Pencil to quickly pause or play it. So let's say I'm going over to Pocket Cast and I'm listening to Primary Technology, my tech show. You should definitely subscribe with the links in the description. You can see it's playing now. And because I mapped that toggle to the Apple Pencil, I can just squeeze it and now it's pause my media. So whether I'm playing music or podcasts, now I can just play and pause by squeezing the Apple Pencil. But let's get to shortcut number 3, and this is the one I'm most excited about. Having a clipboard manager on the iPad is one of the biggest challenges if you're coming from the Mac. There's lots of great utilities on the Mac for that, but third-party apps don't have that ability here on iPad. So I've created this shortcut, and what it does is when you copy something anywhere on your iPad, any text, it's going to get the text from your clipboard, it's going to add it to this third-party app data jar to a specific list, and it's going to keep track of all those clippings. Then when you run this shortcut, it's actually going to ask you a menu question. Do you want to copy something from your past clippings, or are you done? You were just trying to add that clipping to the list. If you tap yes, you'll get a menu option to choose one of the last clippings you saved, and then you can select it and it'll be on your clipboard here on your iPad. Let me show you how this works. I'll go over to one of my bare notes and I'll copy something to my clipboard like the title for this shortcut. I'll hit copy, and now I'm going to squeeze my Apple Pencil, which is going to run that shortcut. It's going to save what I just copied to the clipboard, then this menu is going to pop up. Do you want to grab a previous clipping? If I tap yes, now I'm going to be presented with a list of items that I've copied before and saved to data jar. Now if I want to paste something different, like subscribe, you should definitely subscribe to the channel. Now I can paste, and I'm pasting what I just selected from my clipboard history. In order to set this up, you will need the data jar app, but it's pretty simple. Once you install the app, you just create a new list here, choose list, where it says key, type clipboard, and then it will work with the shortcut that I already have down in the description. And once you do that, you can now have a clipboard manager right on your iPad, triggered with a squeeze gesture on your Apple Pencil Pro. All right, next up, I'm gonna give you a twofer because these are pretty simple, but you can also have an app open upon a squeeze gesture. Fairrite is where I edit all of the podcast here on iPad. I edit exclusively on iPad, all the audio versions of my shows. And because that's mainly what I use the Apple Pencil for, I can map that to the squeeze gesture, just squeeze it, and now it'll open Fairrite from wherever I am over my iPad. I'm going to show you some more powerful app opening and window management shortcuts in a moment, but kind of a bonus shortcut is you can toggle dark mode just with a pencil squeeze gesture. I'll map pencil dark mode to the squeeze gesture, and now wherever I am, let's say I'm in Fairrite, I can squeeze my pencil, and I'm going to go back into light mode. Squeeze it again, and I'm back into dark mode. Now, what if you want to be able to do multiple things for that squeeze gesture on Apple Pencil Pro? Well, you can create a shortcut that presents a menu every time you squeeze the Apple Pencil, and then you can choose from multiple shortcuts that you might want to run. This was an old action button menu that I created back when the iPhone 15 Pro came out. I'll link that video above and down in the description. But now if I squeeze my Apple Pencil, I'll actually be presented with a whole menu of choices. Maybe I want to jump to podcasts, set a focus, or a home scene, jump into camera, Halide, or even better, the Orion app if I want to use my iPad as an external monitor. You can create that menu with as many options as you'd like. Just to give you an idea, this is what it looks like, starting with a choose from menu action. I have lots of menu options here, you can add more, and then you can either do just run shortcut for each menu option, or actually build out the actions here in the long menu shortcut. If you want to just download this action menu that I started creating and then further adjust it, that link is down in the video description. All right, next, I'm trying to give Stage Manager a fair shake, see if I want to use it on my 11-inch M4 iPad Pro, and you can actually toggle Stage Manager via a shortcuts action. You can actually expand the options and show the dock or not, and show recent apps. I'll toggle that off. But now I can program this to my Apple Pencil squeeze gesture. And now wherever I'm in an app, maybe I'm in Safari, if I want to enable Stage Manager, I can just squeeze my Apple Pencil and I'm in Stage Manager mode. I can open up multiple app windows here in Stage Manager. and I can just squeeze my Apple Pencil if I want to return to normal view or split view. In addition to Stage Manager, you can actually have apps open as slide over. So here I have a shortcut where it's going to open Messages as a slide over application. I actually find this pretty useful as an Apple Pencil gesture, because then I can be in another app. Let's say I'm building shortcuts for one of these videos, just squeeze my Apple Pencil Pro and my messages slide in from the right side. Unfortunately, there's no way to squeeze and dismiss the Messages app, so you will have to manually slide it over, but it's nice to quickly access any app you'd like in Slide Over view. But in addition to Slide Over, you can actually use shortcuts to open multiple apps in Split View. So here I've used the action Split Screen between Safari and Bear. I can expand this and actually change the ratio. I can do 2/3 and 1/3 or 50-50. I'll map this to the Apple Pencil squeeze gesture. Now, if there's two apps, maybe I'm about to do some research for Primary Technology, my tech podcast that I mentioned you should follow it down in the video description. I'll open Safari here on the left, Notion here on the right, and I'm ready to go. All right, two more quick ones. You can actually run smart home scenes with HomeKit here with an Apple Pencil squeeze gesture, or what I did here is actually running an intercom scene. This might be more useful as maybe a choose from menu and then selecting smart home scenes, but I thought this would be fun to demo. So let me go back to my Apple Pencil squeeze settings. I'll choose my Pencil home shortcut, and now this should intercom something when I squeeze it.
Hello, this is your Apple Pencil speaking.
There you go. Quickly send intercom messages with a squeeze of Apple Pencil. And finally, if you want a smarter voice assistant on your iPad, you can use the Start Voice Conversation with ChatGPT action. Map that shortcut to your Apple Pencil squeeze gesture. And now wherever you are on your iPad, I can just squeeze it, and it's going to start that ChatGPT voice conversation. Are there any YouTube creators that have a lot of shortcuts videos where I could learn a lot about automation?
For learning about automation and shortcuts, there are several YouTube creators who specialize in this area. Here are a few recommendations. 1. Automation Step-by-Step. This channel provides detailed tutorials on various automation tools and techniques, focusing on practical step-by-step guides.
Well, spoiler, it didn't mention this channel, so I need your help. If you want to learn about even more shortcuts, go ahead and subscribe to the channel. I have lots of playlists, both from Shortcuts 101 and 201, giving you the basics, and a whole playlist of shortcuts requests. And there I build shortcuts that you've asked for. So if you have a shortcut idea or one you're trying to build, leave a comment below this video. I'll do a shortcuts request video very soon. Hit that like button. Don't forget to subscribe to this channel and Primary Technology. Those links are down in the video description, as well as links to download all the shortcuts that I just talked about. If you want to check out the last request video, which gave 15 new shortcuts for iPhone, check out this video right up here. And if you're into 3-in-1 MagSafe chargers, maybe you want to put a new charger on your nightstand, I have reviews of some of the latest right up here and more videos of those coming soon. Thanks for watching. I'll catch you next time.